So on 1st of January 2016 was born an agreement which had the potential to avert the nuclear armed race in the Middle East region. The very agreement that I am talking about is formally known as Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action. And informally, this is what we all of us know as the Iran Nuclear Agreement. Now, who were the participants and negotiators of this agreement? Well, the negotiating partners were the government of Iran plus the P5 or the permanent five members of United Nations Security Council. And then there was this sixth nation that is the biggest economy of European Union, which is Germany. Apart from these seven negotiators were one of the important intergovernmental organization of Europe, that is European Union. So altogether, these eight negotiators came up with this agreement, which had a long-term goal and a very immediate goal to achieve. Now, as far as the long-term goal is concerned, the P5 plus one nations, they had this idea and notion that the agreement should be tasked at dismantling the Iran's nuclear weapon development program or enrichment program to the level that if in future Iran decides to go for developing a nuclear weapon, then it should at least take a time of 1 year. Then, apart from the goals, what was the immediate impact of this agreement on the politics of Middle East? Now, as far as that perspective is concerned, Israel declared this agreement to be too lenient on Iran, and on the other side, Saudi Arab, being the leader of the Middle East politics, it said that if the Iran detonates its first nuclear device, then Saudi Arab will also be willful to go for the nuclear weapons race. Then, after that, what we should remember is that this agreement has, in phase-wise manner, certain limitations on the nuclear enrichment and weapon development program of Iran. Like, say for example, that there is a limitation of 10 years for the further enrichment of the naturally occurring uranium through the centrifuge devices that they have at their Faradao and Natanz nuclear reactors. Also, say for example, for next 15 years from 2016, there will be a limitation to reduce the stockpile of uranium up till 97% of it has to be dismantled, and also the enrichment level of the uranium has been fixed at 3.67%. Now everybody would be wondering that what is this enrichment process? Well, enrichment is a process by which using a nuclear reactor and a centrifuge device, the uranium-235, which is around 0.7% into naturally occurring uranium-238, it is separated using the centrifugal force. Now, when this enrichment of uranium-235 by increasing the concentration is reached up till the level of 5%, then the power generation can be done. And when the same enrichment crosses the limit of 90%, then using the same uranium, the nuclear weapons could be developed. Now, the historical background of this very agreement, it began with the then US President Dwight Eisenhower's historic speech in the year 1953, through which the program Atom for Peace got its genesis. Then it was in the year 1955 when the government of Iran, led by Mohammad Reza Shah Pahlavi, had this agreement with the then US government for the transfer of the technology and the enrichment process of the uranium to Iran. And then happened the Iranian Revolution in 1979, when the supreme leader Ayatollah Ruhollah Khomeini, he assumed the leadership of Iran, and the Iran and US ties then fractured from that very year. This has a very important episode in the history of Iran, when just in the year of revolution, there was this issue of US hostage crisis. So what happened, that some of the members and youth of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard, they went ahead and took the hostage of US embassy staff stationed at Tehran. Now, for the evacuation process, although United States of America and its then president Jimmy Carter planned an Operation Eagle Claw to rescue all the hostages, but due to desert storms, that rescue plan had to be averted. Now, after that, after the 444 days of since the day of this hostage crisis, due to the mediation of Algeria, the crisis could be resolved. But in this process, US and its allies imposed severe economic sanctions and trade embargo over the government and the officials of Iran, which eventually led to the recessionary period of the Iranian economy, and which became a very, very important premise for Iran to kneel down to a compromise to be achieved so that Middle East could be prevented from nuclear armed race. Now, the agreement, when it came into existence on 1st of January 2016, it worked well for next 2 years, but it was until 2018 when Donald Trump, the then US president, withdrew and walked out of this very important deal. And then thereafter, Iran also began its nuclear enrichment program, and it announced that it will not respect and recognize the limitations henceforth. And then there came a light of hope when the change of regime happened in United States of America, and Joe Biden, the new president of US, he signaled that we want to renegotiate the whole Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action agreement. But then in the month of June 2021, the next president who assumed the presidency in Iran is Ibrahim Raisi, who is considered as a hardliner conservativist, and who has also expressed his wish to renegotiate the whole deal. But the whole fate of this agreement lies on the wisdom of these two big leaders of the world right now. So the world is looking forward to this deal, including India, as India also has vested interest in Iran, specifically in the Farzad gas field projects, and also the most important project that is very, very strategic to us, that is the Chabahar port, in which already last year there was this update, as we all are aware of, that China and Iran signed a $400 billion agreement for next 25 years for the various investment into the projects lined up in Belt and Road Initiative. So in this very video, we came to learn about the historical background and the current perspective of Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action, and when this agreement will again be renegotiated, it can provide, or it has the potential for, a prosperous Middle East. So thank you for listening to us, and do keep watching CLAT Possible, such informative video sessions.